Hello, Prism Engineering community. My name is Toby Schnars, and welcome to another Prism Tech Tip, where today we're going to talk about dimensioning to the peak of an arc. Now, this is part of our 25 tips in 25 days to celebrate 25 years of Prism Engineering Incorporated. Prism got started back in 1991, and in 2016, we're still going strong. So for today's tip, we're going to show how we can create a dimension much like the 2.877 dimension shown here. Instead of creating the dimension and then going over to the dimension properties, we can hold the shift key to shortcut the process of dimensioning to the peak of an arc. And this can work both at the drawing level and at the sketch level. Now normally when you create a dimension, the dimension is going to snap to the center of an arc. After that dimension is created, you can manually examine the dimension properties, and you can change that arc condition to either be minimum, to give you the minimum possible point of tangency, or maximum, to give you the maximum possible point of tangency for that dimension. But what we're going to show today is a shortcut where you can hold the shift key to get these values on the fly. Let's take a look at the software to see what we mean. So here we are looking at the SOLIDWORKS 2016 software. You'll see here that if I zoom in on this drawing view and I want to create a new dimension, I can create that dimension by picking this lower line and then picking this arc. When I'm done, what I will have established is what's called an arc condition of center. If I click on this dimension and I go over to the properties for leaders and look down at the bottom, I can see that the arc condition is set to center. If I change that value to min or max, you'll see that the dimension will change to represent the minimum possible point of tangency or the maximum possible point of tangency for that dimension. But this time what I'm going to do is I'm going to begin the smart dimension and I'm going to hold the shift key. And now when I take my mouse over the arc near the peak, you can see that on the fly I was able to establish the maximum possible point of tangency for that dimension. Still in the dimension command, if I select this bottom line and then hold the shift key and select the arc near the bottom, I can establish the minimum possible point of tangency for that dimension. Like I said, the shortcut not only works in the drawing mode, but it also works in sketch mode in SOLIDWORKS. So here, if I wanted to create a dimension to the maximum point of this tombstone shape, I can hold the shift key and select this arc near the peak. There you can see I've established a tangency condition of maximum. I could also create a dimension by holding the shift key and choosing the slotted hole here and the slot over here, giving me a max-max arc condition for the length of that slot. Lastly, if I wanted to control a certain amount of meat between this wall and the slot, I can hold the shift key and establish a relationship for the minimum possible point of tangency, giving me a certain predefined amount of meat here between the slotted hole and the wall. All very useful stuff when you're working in the SOLIDWORKS software, and I think this is one of my favorite time-saving shortcuts. So that concludes the demo. It's a short one, but like I said, it's one of my favorite shortcuts, and it's one that I use all the time to save time in the software. As a reminder, you can either create the dimension and then click the dimension and examine the properties to see and set the arc condition, or you can hold the shift key while creating the dimension and then snap the dimension to the peak, whether it's the minimum or the maximum possible point of tangency. That's it for today's tip. I want to remind you that there are some other great tips available on our Prism Engineering YouTube page. And I want to thank you very much for tuning in today. Remember, this is only one of 25 of our 25 tips in 25 days to celebrate 25 years of Prism Engineering. So be sure to check back in for some more great tips and tricks. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.